بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. اما بعد، نبدا باذن الله تعالى بدراسه كتاب الصلاه. نعم.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. بعد، we're going to now study and move on to study the book of As-Salah, the book of prayer.
As-Salah, نريد أن نتكلم عن الصلاة ونقسم الصلاة إلى قسمين، فريضة ونافلة. نعم.
We want to start talking about the prayer. We want to start studying about the prayer. And we want to divide the prayer into two types. That which is a fariḍa, the obligatory prayers, an obligation, and those which are voluntary.
الفريضة الصلوات الخمس المفروضة.
So the obligatory prayers are the five daily prayers.
وصلاة الجماعة على صلاة الجمعة على ما يسر اجتماعنا بإذن الله تعالى من أنها تجب على الرجال لا على النساء.
And also the Friday prayer, Salat al-Jum'ah, the Friday prayer which men have to pray in congregation and women don't have to.
وصلات العيدين والكسوف على القول بأن العيدين والكسوف واجبة. نعم.
And also the two Eid prayers and the prayer for the eclipse, the lunar eclipse or the solar eclipse, upon the opinion of those people who said that all of these prayers are an obligation and they have to be prayed in congregation. Then after this, we're going to talk about the second type of prayers, which is the recommended or voluntary prayers.
الصلاة لابد لها من شروط وأركان وواجبات، ولا بد أن تصلي ولا تأتي بمبطل ومبطلات الصلاة، ولهذا أهم ما يكون أن تتعلم شروط الصلاة وأركان الصلاة وواجبات الصلاة وكذلك السنة، ولا بد أن تعرف المبطلات حتى لا تقع في مبطل وتكون الصلاة بهذا السبب عافية السلامة باطلة. نعم.
In terms of the prayer, then each prayer has its conditions and its pillars, its obligations, and also those actions which are recommended. And then there are also actions which, if a person does any of these actions, then his prayer becomes invalid or he breaks his prayer. So you have to know, before you start praying, what are the conditions, the shurut, what are the pillars, the arkan, what are the obligatory matters, which are the wajibat, and what are the sunan, those recommended actions. And you also have to know the mubtilat, i.e. those actions which, if you do them, they break a person's prayer and make it invalid.
فشروط الصلاة.
So the conditions of the prayer are
الشرط الأول الإسلام.
The first condition is الإسلام, a person accepting Islam.
فلو صلى المشرك فصلاته باطلة من الصلاة عافية السلام.
So if a person of shirk prays the prayer, then his prayer is not accepted.
من صلى ساب الرب ساب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. من يسجد للصنم من يطوف حول القبور فصلاته باطلة حتى يتوب من هذا. نعم.
A person who insults Allah, a person who insults the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a person who bows down and makes sujood to an idol, a person who makes tawaf around the graves, any of these people, if they pray, then their prayer is not accepted. Why? Because they are in shirk akbar. Until they repent from their shirk, and then their prayer is accepted.
الشرط الثاني العقل، فلو صلى المجنون فصلاته باطلة.
And then the second condition is al-aql, a person having intelligence, and therefore, if an insane person prays, then his prayer is invalid. And more than this is that a person who is drunk or intoxicated, he does not pray.
الشرط الثالث التمييز التفريق بين الأشياء. فإذا كان هذا الذي يصلي يفرق بين الأشياء فصلاته صحيحة، وإذا كان لا يفرق بين الأشياء فصلاته باطلة. صلاة الصغير هل تصح؟ ننظر. إذا كان يميز وفرق بين الأشياء، يعرف أن هذا ماء وهذا نار، تقول له اجلس يجلس، يعرف السؤال والجواب، فصلاته صحيحة وإلا فهي باطلة. نعم.
The third condition for the validity of the prayer is that the small child, the young child, must be able to distinguish, i.e. he's reached an age whereby he can distinguish. He can distinguish between right and wrong and this and that in the various actions. So is the prayer of a small child accepted? We see, we ask him, has he reached the age of at-tamyiz, the age whereby he can distinguish between different things?
الشرط الثالث من شروط الصلاة النية.
The fourth condition from the conditions of the prayer is an-niyya, a person having the intention.
وتقدم معنا أن النية محل القلب والتلفظ بها بدعة.
And we already mentioned that the place in which a person has his intention is the heart. And for a person to speak with the intention or pronounce intention upon this tongue, then this is an innovation, an action which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do.
ورفع الحدث الأكبر والأصغر وهذا تقدم معنا في درس الطهارة.
And also from the conditions of the prayer is a person having exited from the state of impurity, whether it is major impurity or minor impurity, and we've already studied this in the book of الطهارة purification.
فمن صلى وعليه حدث أكبر أو حدث أصغر قبل أن يتوضأ أو يغتسل فالصلاة باطلة.
So whoever prays and he's in a state of major impurity, al-hadith al-akbar, or minor impurity, al-hadith al-asghar, without making ghusl, or without making wudu, then his prayer is invalid and not accepted.
ثُمَّ إِزَالَةَ النَّجَاسَةَ عَنْ ثَلَاثَةِ أَشْيَاءَ عَنَ الْبَدَنِ وَالْبُقْعَةِ وَالثَّوْبِ فَلَوْ صَلَّوْا عَلَى بَدَنِ النَّجَاسَةِ أَوْ عَلَى ثَوْبِ نَجَاسَةٍ أَوْ فِي مَكَانٍ نَجِسٍ فَالصَّلَاةُ بَاطِلَةٌ إِذَا كَانَ قَادِرًا عَلَى إِزَالَةِ هَذِهِ النَّجَاسَةِ عَالِمًا بِوُجُودِهَا. نعم.
And then the next condition for the validity of the prayer is that a person removes or cleans any impurity, any najasa upon his garments or upon his body or upon the earth that he's praying. So therefore, if a person prays a prayer and there's some impurity, some najasa on his body or his garment or the floor that he's praying upon, then his prayer is invalid. As long as a person is aliman,
عالم بوجود النجاسة قادرا على إزالتها.
As long as a person knows that this impurity is on himself or his clothing or the floor, and he also has the ability to remove it and clean it. If he doesn't do so, and he knows and he has the ability to do so, then his prayer is not accepted.
فلو صلى وعليه النجاسة ولكن كان لا يدري بوجود هذه النجاسة وصلى بها فالصلاة صحيحة. نعم.
So if a person prays, he finishes praying, and he didn't know that there was an impurity on his garment or on his body on the floor, he didn't know this, and he's prayed now, then his prayer is correct and accepted.
واستقبال القبلة لابد من استقبال القبلة في صلاة الفريضة وصلاة النافلة وفي كل صلاة. نعم.
And also from the conditions of the acceptance and the validity of the prayer is that a person faces the Qibla. And this is the same whether it's an obligatory prayer or a voluntary prayer.
إلا صلاة النافلة يصح أن يصلي النافلة في السفر فقط حيث توجه به الدابة أو الراحلة أو القطار أو السيارة أو ما إلى ذلك من وسائل المواصلات. نعم.
And the only exception to this, i.e. facing the Qibla, is a person praying the nafil prayers, the voluntary prayers, whilst he is travelling. So whilst he is travelling, he can sit in his mode of transport and pray whichever way the mode of transport is facing.
إذا لابد من استقبال القبلة في صلاة الفريضة وفي النافلة. إلا أن النافلة في السفر يصح أن يصلي حيث توجه به الدابة أو الراحلة أو القطار أو السيارة. نعم. أو الباخرة.
So a person has to face the Qibla, one of the conditions is a person has to face the Qibla in all of his prayers, whether it's an obligatory prayer or whether it's a voluntary prayer. And the only exception to this is if a person is traveling and he's sitting on his mode of transport, whether it's a camel or a horse or a car or a train or a ship, then he prays whichever way his mode of transport is facing.
Thumma أيضاً ستر العورة أو أخذ الزينة في الصلاة. نعم.
And also from the conditions of the validity of the prayer and the correctness of the prayer is a person covering his awra, a person covering his private body parts that should be covered, or a person adorning himself and beautifying himself with the correct clothing.
فأخذ الزينة في الصلاة أو ستر العورة في الصلاة على ثلاثة أقسام.
So a person beautifying and adorning himself with good clothing, or a person covering his awra, his private parts, is of three types.
عورة مغلظة وعورة مخففة وعورة متوسطة.
So you have three types of awra, three types of private parts that should be covered, three types of parts of the body that have to be covered. You have those parts of the body which there is a severe command, or there is a great command to cover, and this is al-awra al-mughallada. And then you have another type of the part of the body which is light, and it has to be covered, but it is still a command which is much lighter. And then you have a type of awra which is in the middle between these two, not as severe as the severe one, and not as light as the lightest one.
Al-awra al-mughallada هي عورة المرأة الحرة البالغة, مرأة وحرة وبالغة تستر جميع البدن إلا وجهها, وعند الأجانب تغطي حتى الوجه. نعم.
The awra which is mughallada, the parts of the body which have to be covered with a very great command or very severe command is the body parts of a woman who is free and she's over the age of puberty. If you find a woman and she's free and she's over the age of puberty, then she has to cover all of her body except her face. If, however, she's in front of non-relatives, i.e. those relatives who are not her mahram, then she has to cover even her face.
والعورة المخففة هي عورة الذكر ابن 7 سنين إلى 10 سنين يستر البول مع الدبر. نعم.
And as for the عورة المخففة, i.e. the body parts which have to be covered, however the command is less, is the private body parts, the private parts of a young boy who's from 7 to 10, he has to cover at least his front private parts and his back private parts.
وما عدا العورة المغلظة والعورة المخففة هي عورة متوسطة يستر من السرة إلى الركبة مع استحباب ستر العاتقين وأخذ كامل الزينة في الصلاة. نعم. العورة المتوسطة هي ما عدا العورة المغلظة والمخففة يستر جميعا يستر من السرة إلى الركبة مع استحباب ستر العاتقين وأخذ كامل الزينة في الصلاة.
And then you have the third type of awra which is between these two levels, and this is a person, a man, the obligation is for him to cover that which is between his navel all the way to his knees, and it is recommended for him to cover up to his shoulders, يعني منكبين.
نعم, استحباب ستر العاتقين وأخذ كامل الزينة في الصلاة, لأنه بهذا قال الله سبحانه وتعالى يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد, أي عند كل صلاة. نعم.
And the recommendation for him is to cover all the way to his shoulder and also to wear nice and beautiful clothes, so beautify himself with good clothes, because Allah said in the Quran, O children of Adam, beautify yourselves with every prayer.
إذا العورات ثلاثة, مغلظة, مخففة, متوسطة.
And therefore we have three types of awra. They are the awra al-mughallada, which has to be covered very severe, and then we have an awra which is mukhaffafa, which is less and weaker or light, and then we have an awra which is between these two.
عورة المرأة الحرة البالغة جميع البدن إلا وجهها, عند الأجانب تغطي حتى الوجه.
So all of the body of a woman who is free and she's over the age of puberty, it has to be covered apart from the face. As for if she's in the presence of people who are not her relatives, not her mahram, then she has to cover even her face.
والعورة المخففة الذكر ابن 7 سنين 10 سنين يستر القبل والدبر. نعم.
And the least form of awra is the awra of a young boy from up to 7 or 10 years old. He has to cover his private parts, the front and the back.
وما عدا المرأة الحرة البالغة والذكر بين 7 سنين 10 سنين كلها البقية عورتهم متوسطة يستر من السرة إلى الركبة مع استحباب ستر العاتقين وأخذ كامل الزينة في الصلاة. نعم.
And apart from these two, you have a man who has to cover himself from his navel all the way down to his knees, and the recommendation is for him to cover all the way up to his shoulders and also wear good and beautiful clothes.
ومن شروط الصلاة كذلك دخول الوقت.
And from the conditions of the prayer is the entering of the correct time.
فلا يصح أن يصلي قبل الوقت.
So a person is not allowed to pray before the time of the prayer.
أو يتعمد إخراج الصلاة عن وقتها.
Or that on purpose he delays the prayer until after the time is gone.
إذا لابد أن يؤدي الصلاة في وقتها.
And therefore, a person has to fulfill and pray his prayer in its time.
إلا إذا كان لديه رخصة بأن يجمع جمع تقديم بين الظهر والعصر أو جمع تأخير كذلك بين الظهر والعصر أو المغرب والعشاء. إذا كان لديه رخصة فله أن يجمع إما جمع تقديم أو جمع تأخير. وإلا فلا بد أن يصلي كل صلاة على وقتها. نعم.
So a person has to pray every single prayer in its correct appointed legislated time, unless he has an allowance from the Sharia. As an example, a person is traveling. He's traveling a journey. And therefore, he can either pray both Dhuhr and Asr in the time of Dhuhr, or he can pray Dhuhr and Asr in the time of Asr, or he can pray Maghrib and Isha in the time of Maghrib, or he can pray Maghrib and Isha in the time of Isha.